Hey, what's going on, guys? Krosama here, and today we're taking a look at some new events, some new banners, as well as the new arena requirement and my build that I have for that. Now, we do have the new event, which I'm actually really excited for, which is the Crimson Anomaly. This is pretty cool because this is the first kit I built whenever I got back into modeling, like building model kits. I think it's the Archie, right? I didn't see it up there. So it's the Archie Gundam. Basically, it's from like a whole line of different throne mobile suits and is like the final form of them. But it looks really cool. I love its sword, which is also like a beam cannon or, you know, beam rifle, however you want to, you know, well, beam rifle, it says it right there. But it looks really good and it's super stylized. So I cannot wait to have this one in my collection. I hope it's actually going to be good because it does have fangs that's on the side skirts. So having fangs and it's going to have a really versatile weapon, I think it's going to make for a fairly good mobile suit, but we'll see. I don't really know how it's going to be. Now, just to backtrack a little bit, we are going to have a new standard Gunpla, you know, pickup that you can get. Now, the banner is actually going to feature mostly the high mobility word tag mobile suits. So it is going to be the Tall Geese as well as the Death Scythe, and you're going to have a couple others in there, but these are probably going to be the ones you're going to want to get. I would actually say especially the Death Scythe because it is mostly defense oriented. So if you do want a defensive mobile suit, that's probably going to be the one to get. And I would actually like to get a lot more Death Scythe suits because I think all I have is the body and the head, so I definitely need a lot more. Now, going back to the actual event, we are going to have multipliers. It's going to be for the 00 Quant Full Saber. We're going to have the Gundam XC, which I do have quite a bit of parts for, so it should be good. The Dynamis, which I have quite a few parts for that as well. You're going to have Archie Gaia Gundam, which we just now got. Susanoo, which we just got, I think, 2 events ago. Kyrios, which was like 5 events ago. Natalie, which was like 8 events ago. GNX, GN 13, and we got Archer. So quite a bit of green as well as some blues that you can go ahead and utilize for this event and try and rack up as many coins as possible. Now, going into the AI pilots, you're gonna have quite a few. You got Lalala Sune. Oh man, I'm butchering these names. Cessna Fsei, which I don't have. Louise, you got Meister Bushido. Mr. Bushido, Patrick, and Sergei, I think that's how you pronounce it. But yeah, you're gonna utilize those guys and, you know, just getting some extra percentage. Now, here we have the Gunpla Path to Mastery. So this looks pretty interesting. This is recommended for those who have made it to Chapter 3. Collect rewards for mission challenges to tune up parts into 5-star, which is fantastic because I would love to get more 5-star parts. And any chance I can get some awakening stuff, hey, I'm all game for it. So this event is going to start on the 11th and it's going to end on the 11th as well. I'm reading that correctly, right? Am I reading this correctly? Oh, okay, the 11th. So it's going to be 2030. So you have 10 years to complete this event. So hopefully you can make it in time. But it features a series of missions requiring a variety of strategic approaches. Okay. So, I mean, it might be just some little challenges here and there, but regardless, complete them and you're going to get some good parts. Now, please note, only your own Gunpla may sortie into there, so you're not using any relief or ally Gunpla for the mission, so make sure your main mobile suit is actually pretty beefy. Now, for the new pilots, we do have Lalal. I know she's from the original mobile suit Gundam, if I'm not mistaken. So she's going to be in it as a 4-star and Louise. Not really too sure where. I think she's from 00. She looks like a 00 character. But yeah, we got these two characters coming in. Tagging on to this, we're going to have a Valentine's Day capsule event. I was really not thinking that we're going to have anything Valentine's Day related. Like maybe a skin or something. I don't know. Maybe like something else, like a new bear guy. But the fact that they're doing the 00 Quant as the Valentine's Day is still kind of odd. Because what does 00 Quant Full Saber have to do with Valentine's Day? To see maybe the bear guy F, like the family bear guy, or Mr. Bear guy, whatever, or Papa Bear guy, I think it's called. Seeing something like that would have probably been a little bit cooler, or even Petite Guy, something. Yeah, I think that would have been pretty nice, but I mean, hey, they're going to make this the banner. And trust me when I say I am pulling on this because I love the 00 Quant Full Saber. It's one of my favorite 00 suits to date. The drop rate is going to be higher, so that's going to be a great thing. And we're also going to have a Valentine's Day coin exchange. So you can definitely get some of these coins exchanged for different parts. And let's say you got box expansion tickets and you got the gold coupon, which I think is only going to give you 10,000 coins, if I'm not mistaken. Now, also here, you got available once per day is going to be a 3-star or higher park guaranteed capsules. Not really great for the fact that it's still a 3-star, but hopefully the drop rate is going to be a little bit higher. Trying to read through it. You can open daily 3-star or higher park guaranteed capsules by using 90 Haro chips. So that's pretty good. Let's see. Well, it's 90. Oh, okay. Just 90 Haro chips to open 4-star park drop rate doubled. Okay, so yeah, that's a good chance to get a bunch of 4-stars. I think you're paying a little bit more to get a single drop, if I'm reading this correctly. And it looks like 2-star or below parts will not appear in the daily, so you're going to get a minimum of 3. There's not going to be any green parts, and the drop rate for 4 is going to be doubled. So this is something I'm probably going to utilize, because if these capsules are going to be really good, I mean, like, so far what I'm seeing right here in the front, you got Barbatos, you're going to have Strike, you got Gundam, Exia, you got Sengoku Astray, which most of them already have except for the Exia. I still need to complete that. But we'll see. I mean, depending on what's going to be in that banner, because if it's all crap, then I'm not going to be interested. Next, we're going to have a login bonus, so some pretty good stuff. We got 500,000 capital, which I'm all about capital. Give me as much capital as possible. We got some new energy recovery strong. That's going to be amazing. You got some more nippers, which I do need because I've been upgrading a lot of stuff. So this is actually not a bad one. And then the 500 horror chips at the end is going to be fantastic. All right, so for the main topic of this video, I wanted to talk about the new arena, which is 1v1. And it's going to have the condition, you need to have the active word tag high mobility active. So, I mean, you can obviously see some things right here of which I'm using. So we are going to have the Blitz Gundam, which is a high mobility, the O, which is going to be high mobility, Queble, Enhanced Shield, I think that was from the Hazel, if I'm not mistaken, the TR1 Hazel. So you got a bit, and there's other mobile suits out there. I think the Death Scythe is definitely one that you can utilize for high mobility. But personally, I just went with something that's kind of like a mix mash of stuff. Obviously, I could have went super hard and just went like really cheap and used either the bisect legs, or I could have used the iron impact mace. I could have went with the Trans Am Raid with Exia, but I was like, you know what? I never really utilized the beam rifle from the original Gundam to use last shooting, so I went with that route, and this is basically what I'm using. It's super weak. It's specialty is going to be, you know, primarily shooting, and it's not that great because look, I'm using a lot of slots that are EX skills, but obviously I'm not using them. The reason being, I really couldn't get everything organized the way I wanted to, so that way I had active traits being utilized. A lot of it was just kind of empty traits, like things that said if you're utilizing speed, and I'm like, I'm not using speed, I'm using technique. And then I had one that was like, if technique, then your melee power increases. And I'm like, no, I need attack, special attack. Oh, not special attack, shooting attack. So this is the best I got. And you can see even the Blitz legs right there, they're not even being utilized. Best thing I got is the Beam Zanba, which is technique. And I got EX skill power boosted 20%. So we'll see how it works out, but my attack is only going to be 8,600, and I don't even have a blue gear part for shot attack. I only have a green right now. So, yeah, it's not looking that promising, but I was like, you know what? I do want to try something different, and this is the way the mobile suit's going to look. So the deal is utilizing the head of the Talkies, I get that power boost for shot attack. Utilizing the Blitz body, I get the invisibility, and I'm going to get an increase in shot attack. And then using last shooting, I'm going to get a massive attack, you know, pretty much popped off. But yeah, this is my high mobility suit. If I really wanted to, I could have used the funnels for the Queble backpack, but I think it looks good. I like the way it looks. It's pretty, you know, obscure, to be honest. But yeah, I'm pretty much digging it. And you are gonna have the Blitz body and the Blitz legs, so it has a little bit more Blitz than everything else. So I'm down for it, man. I think it looks cool. It's pretty baller. But yeah, I definitely like to see what you guys have constructed in your build. But yeah, post it in the comments, not your pictures, but let me know in the comment section below what kind of mobile suit you're using. Or if you want, you can tag me on social media such as Facebook. You can tag me on Instagram. Or you can tag me on Twitter and show me exactly what you're working with when it comes to the Gunbreaker. But kind of ran my lips on pretty much long enough. So that's it for me, guys. Definitely thank you all for watching. And I'll be seeing you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.